finally here. Many years coming. Probably should have launched this first. We all know my lack of desire to clean interiors, and so I should have tackled this first before pressure washing or anything, because it would have made my life a lot easier. In fact, Michelle said, make sure that you give my endorsement that this is my favorite thing that you've ever done. And so the vacuum system that we did at my house, those of you who've been following along for the last, the last 6 months, Mike and I, Mike installed the hide-a-hose system. So you pull the hose out of the wall and it sucks back into the wall and it's super, super quiet. Actually, we have this unit up in the attic, and it's magical. It's magical to have the capability of that. So what I'm going to do is very vlog style, shotgun style here, a very informal. We're going to do an informal launch to Inside the Hex members. When you're watching this video, it'll be Monday. This video probably is up Saturday or Sunday. And so Monday we'll launch for Inside the Hex members. We're going to send out an email to everybody. We do have some availability concerns of these. Now, the unit, we should be able to crank out a lot of them, but accessories and being able to put it all together, hose reels, all that stuff could be a holdup. So we want to give our Hex members first crack. We want to give them the ability to lock your place in line. So we're opening for pre-order with an expected delivery around August 1st. You know, that's the hope. But just remember, we're in the world of supply chain issues. I don't want to overpromise and underdeliver. I know that people have been beating down my door to say, Matt, I need this. It's very similar to when I first launched the pressure washing system. I wasn't ready for it. We're much, much more ready for this than I was for the pressure washing system. And I was out of stock on the pressure washing system. People would pre-order and we'd ship them as they came. And so I'd encourage people to lock it down. It is really, really, really good. I'm really pleased with what we come up with here. Part of the reason why I haven't ever launched, because I've never found anything I fell in love with. And so my conversation with Grant in Modern Day, I feel like I found the oracle of vacuum cleaning, vacuum systems. He's like 45 years into his career, into creating central vac systems. So I explained my unique circumstances, what I was looking for, and we were able to sort of accomplish that. So let's start with the unit, talk about what it is, how it works, and what my choices were. And so this is one of the prototypes that I tested. This is the final unit. We're actually gonna send it without the sticker on it. I requested that because I'm gonna pull the frickin' stupid sticker off, but some people will probably want this. And so the sticker's gonna come in the box because I hate having to peel stickers off and having to deal with issues with, you know, trying to get it off. I think this would probably come off pretty easily. But I wanted them to send it in the box. The box is going to look something like this. Everything's going to come in a box from Modern Day. And so I think our first shipment of 50 complete should be here, or again, around mid-July. So I'm saying August 1st, but hopefully we can ship it out sooner. So the main unit is a 15 amp. And this is where we're able to get more suction, more flow. You're going to need a dedicated or a very, very clean 15 amp circuit, 110 volt or 120 volt, 15 amps. Because believe it or not, when the switch is turned on and when you're not sucking up anything is when you're getting the biggest amperage draw. And it's designed to draw as much amperage as possible, because the more amperage we have, the more water lift or suction capability we have. And so I chose to do a 15 amp unit because if you do a 13 or 12 and a half amp, I just don't feel like we got enough output from it. And so we've made that choice to say, you know what, figure it out. Get yourself a clean circuit, get yourself a dedicated circuit, because I think it's really worth it. If you're gonna go central vac, or you're gonna go central vac in your garage, I think that this is a little bit more custom-oriented for a custom-oriented customer. If you can't get that done, then buy the flex vacuum or some rigid or something like that. So this looks just like all of them. All the canister vacuums look the same. There's frickin' 1,000 companies. Really what it comes down to is the motor, the packing, so how they silence it, and so we have some choices to make. And so these were my two sort of final, I don't know how many of these I've gotten. I mean, I've chased, you know, probably 20 different companies, had conversations with, I can't even remember half the names over the last 3 or 4 years. I got hot on it and then fizzled out. Partly because I hate cleaning interiors, but modern day, I kept coming back to this. So my friend Nick Jones out in the Boulder, I guess he's Golden, Colorado area. So he's up in the mountains. He built the Morton building you saw me tour many years ago. And he had a modern day vacuum that was his choice. So I just kept coming back to that. We put a modern day in the Atlanta garage, the big Atlanta garage we did. And every time I've experienced them, it was so much better than all the other ones I had laying around here, all the different prototypes, all the different trials, the various brands that I brought in here over the years. And I brought in some Nilfisk stuff. I forget what that one that our friend in Hawaii has that he liked that one. I didn't like it. I gave it to Tommy, said, get this thing out of here. I just wasn't in love, and I wanted to fall in love. And so I finally, probably about a year ago, I just called Modern Day. I said, hey, here's what I'm looking for. I don't want the traditional, now this isn't the vacuum, this is actually a separate canister, but I don't want the 8 gallon. I don't want the monster, 5, 8, 10 gallon monster. We don't need that in the garage. I want something small, I want something compact. And he said, I think I have the one for you. He said, we're gonna need to modify it, but I've been using one of our Flowmaster style. This is called the CV300 Flowmaster, one of our Flowmasters, and we've been modifying it for pet groomers when they're in mobile environments. And the reason why it was so good is because it's really, really, really quiet. And I said, yeah, but does it have enough output? How much suction can we get out of it? Can we make it perform really well? He says, I think we can. And then he gave me a choice, and we're going to dig into this in a little bit more detail in the future, and that's really the difference between these two here. He gave me a choice of motor, and if you read anything, if you go into the deep, dark areas of vacuum, pressure washing back in the day when I got started in that, pressure washing, the information wasn't available at all. It was really hard to find online. We didn't know much about orifices. Short guns really didn't exist. Quick disconnects were not a thing, or a very, very uncommon thing, especially in stainless. And so, you know, like General Pump had them in their catalog, MTM had it in their catalog, but no one was really buying them. Most pressure washing companies advised against doing quick disconnects. And then we had, you know, I had a choice to head down the path of a triplex style or a crankshaft driven style pump, which is very common on gas pressure washers, higher output pressure washers. The AR professionals use a triplex style pump, which in all specifications is a superior pump. And then I had these companies like Krenzla that had, it's like Porsche. It's like the engine's in the rear of this car here, and it shouldn't be. It's a terrible design. It's not the way to do it. You'd want it in front of the front axle or in front of the rear axle. You'd want a mid-engine car. And yet Porsche's been able to refine. And, you know, reminds me very much of Krenzla. You've been able to refine the engine or the motor of a radioaxial pump and get something that I just prefer. But I still wasn't convinced because in the world of vacuums, there's three major types, but really there's simply, you can simplify it down to two. You have a through flow, which is cheap, it's lightweight, it's smaller in design. So the way that this thing works, it sucks the stuff up through and all the dirt and debris and all of that stuff. Now there's a filter in here, but it passes by of the electrical components of the motor. And it's lighter, it's cheaper, it's what you'll find in pretty much all inexpensive vacuums, upright vacuums, is a through flow type design. Now the commercial style, much heftier, you can see the size difference, it weighs quite a bit more. This is the tangential discharge. And so this has a bypass. It has a separate cooling, so the we'll dig into this in detail. We'll probably have Grant come down and teach us all about how the stuff works as we get deeper and deeper into the vacuum stuff, and continue to chase, you know, perfection, if you will, figure out what's the best option for us. But essentially what happens is this uses the suction to cool the motor. This one has separate intakes to cool the motor. That's why you have this pipe that kind of comes out the side. It's just, I know I'm not saying that very accurately, but the simplicity of this is that because its cooling is superior, this will last years and decades, or this will last in our garages 15 years. Now, my argument to Tommy when we're developing this is, well, I don't want this, but let's see what it's like. Let's see what it's like. Because Grant kept telling me, he's like, I'm telling you, for what you're looking to accomplish, I know that the motor is inferior. You're gonna be complaining. You're gonna think that it's not the choice. So I'm gonna send you both, and he was right. So we can put any motor we want in this thing, but here's the difference: 72-ish decibels, 59-ish decibels. Now, and we've talked about this many, many times, remember that the decibel rating, the way that the human ear hears, is not in a linear fashion. The output or the water lift and CFM rating is about 5% different, but the sound in decibel rating is somewhere around 15-16% different, but it's not a linear 16%. It's, you know, somewhere on the magnitude of, so if you're 8 or 9 or 10 decibels quieter, you're looking at more like 100 times quieter, you know, in real life. The other thing that I'm going to test in the future, when we start to get into all the sophisticated testing, when I start comparing these to other canister vacuums, other motors, other options, the other thing we're going to start testing is the frequency of things. I wish I would have done that when I tested all the pressure washers, because there's frequencies that are annoying and frequencies that are not. And so think of this as, it's operating at roughly the same volume as my speaking voice right now, maybe a little bit quieter. Think of this as operating as loud as what would be equivalent, like my air compressor running. Actually, no, my air compressor is quieter than this by quite a bit. So there's some things that we can do to both of these. And so that was my other question is, okay, I want more output. I want the motor that's going to last 25 years in my garage. What if I do some sound deadening? What if we put a muffler on the thing? And then with the bigger, beefier, heftier motor, how much am I going to notice? And we're going to show you all this stuff in the future. I know I'm talking at you now. This is a very informal launch of the vacuum system. I'm going to show you all of this. Tommy and I spent, you know, hours just vacuuming out. We were pulling in employees' cars and going back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. Okay, this is 100 times louder. It's quite a bit louder, but it has this big beefy motor. It's not really that much bigger in footprint. It draws the same amount of current, but, you know, how much more suction am I going to get? Is it worth it? And then this is where we're going to start to dig in, and I'm going to become more educated on this and be able to explain this in better fashion in the future. But when they rate these things, and I'll show you the charts in the future, but there's flow, and then there's suction. I think I might have that right. Anyway, when you have a hose, so when you have the hose open, so I have it plugged into this. Just assume I have it plugged into the vacuum. And the hose is open. This is a 1.5-inch hose. So my 1.5-inch hose is open, and it's just sucking air. It's drawing the most amount of current, so the motor's working the hardest, believe it or not. And the advantage is, even though the motor's working the hardest, it's cooling the best because there's air flowing through the system. And when you're open, you're getting maximum flow or maximum CFM. So this one is rated at roughly 130 CFM. This one's rated at 138 CFM, something like that. Don't hold me to the specs. I'm just pulling from memory here. We'll get into the detailed, accurate, measured specifications as we kind of go through this process of discovery. So I've already tested all this, but I just don't have it in my head. We're going to actually formally do it on camera with you, and I'm going to buy tens of thousands of dollars of other canister vacuums that we're going to compare. If I find something better, then we'll punt this and we'll do something else. So CFM means nothing. It means very little in our calculations and our use case, because when it's open, we're not doing anything. It's just sucking air through. We're not vacuuming anything. Now, if I take this and put it in a bucket of water, or I seal it up like this, that's when I get my water lift or my maximum water lift function. But what happens is when you do that, the CFM or airflow goes to effectively zero. Now, if I'm actually sucking something up, so let's say that I had a, let's say that I put a crevice tool on, or if I'm using something like this, I'm going to take the orifice size from, say, 2.0 or wide open to down to something like maybe 0.5 or 0.65. So we're talking about operating suction. And then if I seal it, my orifice changes as well. And so what really matters when you're looking at vacuums, it's not the air watts. It's not the maximum flow. It's not the maximum water lift capability or suction. It's how much effective use or how much effective suction do I get when I have the orifice at operating size. So if I'm using this, or I'm using a crevice tool, or I'm using something like a floor operating tool. So these are the things I'm going to show you, how we're going to measure that, how we're going to test that. And so when you're looking at specs on a sheet, and we found that, you know, the specs on the sheet on this are, you know, 10 to 15% better. It's, you know, it's 10 or 12 decibels louder. Would those specs be noticed and worthwhile? But if you do the calculation when the orifice is closed up and you're sucking things out of a carpet, this thing being 100 times quieter, and the fact that it has almost the exact same suction, it's like within 3 or 4%, according to our calculations, it isn't worth the loudness that you're getting from this machine. So I do think that long term, you know, for like detail shops and things like that, maybe it makes sense to put the tangential on and do this one and offer this one. But for almost all of us, and even most detail places, you're going to want the quieter, more sound deadened 58, 59 decibel mufflered version of our CB300 of the Obsessed Garage vacuum system. So what I'm getting at is we're launching with this. This is what I have in my house at home. This is what I have in Helen. This is what I have actually. I'm redoing this here because I didn't like how it looked. We tried a undermount design. So we're going to have a video coming out where Mike shows you how to custom install. I'm going to have him paint all the tubing and paint everything black so that it matches. I'm going to show you how that all works. So the system, or the main unit, it's a lot to tell you, to basically tell you that I made this is the Krenzler choice. This is the choice I made for our vacuum system. And this is what I've made for me. And I know that, you know, many of you in the future may want the tangential, but I'm never putting this in my garage. It's too freaking loud. This is crazy loud. This is crazy quiet. So it's funny, I didn't even think about this, but one problem I had, which we found, which we've now solved, is that our bags were not rated for 143-ish inches of water lift, 140-ish CFM. And so it was actually blowing through the back of the bag. So I had them redesign the bag. So these bags have been redesigned. And so this bag has a different part number, where when the bag gets installed, By the way, we'll have all these accessories. You can even see inside of my, you should never get dirt inside of your vacuum system. We just did some testing with Modern Day, and I said, hey, I love the vacuum. It's freaking amazing. But I think it has too much power. It's blowing through the gosh darn bag. We went back to his supplier and said, hey, here's what we're doing. They did some testing and sucked up a bunch of junk. And so now the bags are redesigned and better. But these things are so freaking simple. There's two inlets. So we sent it with a plug. So you have a plug. And then you have the little elbow inlet here. All right, so you have the little elbow. And you can pick the side if you want it left or right. So you can pick the side on your own, and you have the option. You have the option to choose. And you have the bag. The bag goes in. Really simple. The bag goes on whichever side you decide to put the elbow. And then our new bag will not allow. It can handle the higher flow and higher suction of our device. The motor's down here inside, so all the motors in here. So our first two iterations they sent us, I said, can we quiet it down more? Can we make it quieter? I think our first one was like 64 decibels, and then we got it down to 62 because he did some packing. And he said, I think I have another idea. I haven't opened this one up to see what he's done, but there's even, because I don't want to mess it up, but there's even more packing inside of here. And then we even have a new rounded muffler, which is quieter than the square muffler. It has basically more sound deadening material inside. And so your basic setup will look like so. What I'm going to do to quiet this down even more, I'm going to turn the muffler down, and then we're going to 90 out the wall. So this is the exhaust. So you have your intake, and you have your exhaust, and then you also have your bypass. So because this doesn't have an external bypass, if you like sucked up or if it got too hot, this will blow off. This one won't blow off any dirt, but we shouldn't get anything blowing past because we have filters, we have the bag, and so you really shouldn't get anything coming out of this end. But the muffler quiets it down quite a bit. And so that's how we get down to between the packing, the muffler setup. You can run it just like this, and it'll operate at somewhere around, 59 decibels, depending on where you stand in your garage and how tall your ceilings are and all of that stuff. So in other words, you can stand right next to it, have a conversation just like this, and it's at roughly the same volume as I'm speaking to you right now. The mount system, really simple. Told you, I'm all over the place here, but I just wanted to tell you kind of where we're at. The mount system is just this simple plate. I mean, there's not much to this. I mean, it weighs 20 pounds. And so you can hit a single stud. You can probably get away with four drywall anchors, some heavy duty anchors. I wouldn't recommend that. You're gonna wanna hit a stud if you can, or and block. And so the simple mount just goes like that. Super, super easy, super simple. Your switch is here, on off. We'll have more coming where we'll have handle switches and wireless RF switches and stuff like that. I don't find that stuff necessary, but I'm sure Tommy will want to develop that for you all. So we'll head down that path in the future. So to kind of wrap up our different motors, our different options, I'm telling you, I'm being completely transparent with you. This is better. This is quieter. I think for our applications in the garage, the bigger, bulkier, heavier, louder, longer lasting version is not worth it. This is like $150 or $180 or something like that. I think this one's like closer to $300 to $350. It's just not worth it. We don't want it to be louder. This thing works so frickin' well. It has almost identical specs with what we're doing in our garage here. I think, don't hold me to this, but I think this has like a 6 or 7 year warranty on it. These things have been around for like frickin' 70 years or something, 50 years. We're not gonna have an issue with with the through-flow motor. I'm telling you, unless you're doing really nasty stuff, even then, I mean, the filters in it should allow it to flow right through, go into your bag, and you're good to go. Again, we will be developing some bigger storage solutions for detail shops and from professional applications as well, because that area I think is underserved. Unless you have a really good central vac company in your town, they're just not there. I have found that no one's really dialed in or digged into the car world as much as I'd like. I'm sure there's some little pockets, you know, locally in some towns where you have a good vacuum guy, but you know, for nationally, you're going to have a hard time finding someone. So we'll probably develop this in the future. We're talking about all the pricing to get on obsessedgarage.com by the time you're watching this. Just the bare standalone unit, I think, is like $660 or something like that. So not crazy money. This would be closer to probably double that. And so we'll head down that path if necessary. But again, all you guys that have detail shops and stuff, you're gonna want this. It's so quiet. It's so smooth. It's so freaking awesome. I'm telling you, this is what you're gonna want to do. And then simple plug. You just have a simple. It comes with a little 90 plug, and then a simple, you know, three prong, normal 110 volt plug-in plug. So the accessories. This is where we're struggling. So we've compiled the best that exist. It's not freaking good enough. And so this adds a few hundred bucks in cost, which isn't crazy because this stuff costs nothing to make, I'm sure. So we have our little brush for cleaning, you know, cleaning your interior. I do like this thing as well for sucking up like center consoles and vents. We also have, we had a custom one made, a little shorter. And then we have the longer, sort of more pliable version of the crevice tool. So this combination, and then this actually works extremely well on carpets. The thing I don't like is it tends to come off when I'm using it, but it's the best one that I found. And so the accessories we'll dig into. I'll make a dedicated accessory video showing you operation of all this stuff, I promise. I just wanted to get this video up for you so you can, those who want to be early adopters can. But this is a full suite of accessories, pretty much everything I found we needed. You have the little turbo carpet brush. This thing is insane. You'll see how this thing works. It's pretty awesome. So the accessory kit or the accessory package, as well as the hose. We're not going to do this Christmas tree looking hose. It's going to be gray. But the other thing that we learned is that to do a 1 1/4 or 1 inch hose or some sort of metric version of a hose, it just they tend to, the frequency gets crazy and they tend to whistle too much. And so 1 1/2 inch hose is the way to go. We have a screwed on swiveling coupler, and then we have an adapter that will stay on this basically permanently, and then when we're dealing with all of our accessories, we just simply plug in, you know, and so then we have options to do the various types of accessory tools to be able to do whatever we want inside of the car. This tool here is amazing for Swiss tracks because of how it seals. I'll show you operation of that. You know, our short stubby crevice tool, which I find myself using almost on the entire car. And then when I have something really tight, that's when I'll put the, you know, the adjustable on. We thought about doing the flex accessories, but there's some disadvantages to those. Again, this is not super high quality stuff. It's the best functional that currently exists. I've talked to everybody. We've called everywhere. You know, if you guys know of something that I don't know of, send it to me. Shoot me an email, matt@obsessedgarage.com. We're going to work with some of our vendors, some of our partners to possibly completely flip the accessory market on its head. And I'm open to suggestions on things. If you guys have something that you'd like us to make, it's going to be a significant investment. It's going to take us some time. But I did want to get a vacuum system for myself, and I want it to be great. And knowing that we need something to make it work, I think we have the unit. I think this is the vacuum. I think this is, you know, I'm gonna try to improve it, but I don't think we're gonna be able to. I think this is as good as it gets. We'll see how it goes over time. We'll see, and then we'll. But the accessories, is there's a lot to be desired. I'm telling you that now. But this suite, will satisfy all the things that you need. It will get everything done that you need to get done. You know, we do have it. It does have a swivel on the end, which helps keep the hose under control. And then we're going to continue to develop solutions. We looked at doing socks on the end of the hose. They don't function very well. So there's a lot of opportunity for us to modify and to figure out ways to make things perform better. So on the website is going to be, there's going to be four packages. First package is going to be this, as you see it, muffler. It's going to have a hose, a 50-foot hose. The hose looks like this, by the way. So this is the prototype, but this is the gray hose. So it's going to be gray and black, which is going to be really slick looking. So this is the actual hose. This is actually one of our holdups. We're waiting on this to come. So we're going with the gray, white, black theme. So it comes with a 50-foot hose. I don't have a wall mount solution, so for those of you who want to just keep costs down, I think it's $925. It'll be on the website. Those of you who are HEX members that are going to buy early, you get your discount on that. You're 10% off and free shipping on it. Shipping of this is obviously going to be a lot of money, so I'm going to have to eat that for all of you HEX members that buy it. But it'll come with a 50-foot hose, the unit, and the accessory package. So fully functioning setup. And then you have to figure out, well, you're gonna put your hose in your cabinet, you're gonna mount the hose on the wall somehow. I haven't found a mount that I like to hang the hose yet, but for those of you who don't wanna swing the extra money for the hose reel, we're giving you that option. So that's option one. Option two is all of that I just explained, but with a hose reel. You can get this in black, blue, gray. And we generally will have these in stock. We're having these made by Cox. This looks bulky. It looks heavy. Once you mount it on the wall, there's not a better winding experience. You don't want an auto retract for something big like a 1.5-inch hose. And so I'm going to suggest, and so I took the blue one off the wall, and I'm having Mike patch my wall and change the configuration of it. I want him to black it out like we did in Helen. And so I'm going to be taking my blue reel and converting it over to a black reel. Black or gray would be my suggestion. Just think about how clean this will look. If I were you, hopefully at some point, nobody makes, they don't make vacuum PVC in any color but white. And so that's another potential development, make it in gray. There is PVC, but not vacuum specific PVC. It's a little thinner walled. It has a specific design to it to make sure that you don't end up with any flow issues, so it flows best. And so what I'm gonna have Mike do is just freaking paint this. You know, I'm gonna spray paint this and so everything matches. So that's something you may wanna consider when you're kind of custom setting this up. And so with the hose reel, the way that we're designing it, the way that we're sending it in the main package, so when you add the hose reel on, let me get that pricing. Yeah, with the hose reel, it's $1,300, and it's going to include a little piece of a gray hose like this. Not this color. It'll be the color of the regular hose where you would connect the hose reel to the vacuum. I don't like that, and so I made Tommy come up with, we're going to figure out a package as well for hard piping, because most of you are going to mount, if you mount the hose, if you mount the unit to the right or left, remember you have, you can go either side if you want, depending on your garage configuration. But if you mount your CV300, your main canister vac, if you mount that on the side, it makes sense. Just get a little piece of whip hose and just kind of, that way you can kind of snake it however you want. But we're going to give people the option to do a custom pipe as well. It'll have to be white. The reason why we didn't love the white, notice the white's different colors. So you have different colors on the fittings. And so again, once you get this set up, you're never going to move it. You're never going to touch it. And so I think the way to go would be to paint it. And even if the paint doesn't, just get paint that will stick to plastic. And so that's going to be an option as well in the store. But in that $1,300 kit, it's coming with a piece, I believe, like a 4 or 5 foot piece of hose that you'll cut to length. It'll make your install much, much easier. Mount the hose reel, mount the canister, and then you just snake a little piece of hose, then trying to cut this exactly to fit. And so we're going to make this will be cheap, but this is going to be an option that we're going to add on in the future. We'll see how it goes. If everybody's buying this, then I'll talk Tommy into forget the hose. Let's do the piping. Remember, you're early adopting here. Then the other two packages, $1,455 is a full hide a hose on wall solution. And then there's a $1,400 version of a full hide a hose in wall solution. So you've seen that at my house. Go back and watch the video. We'll put the link in the description. But you can watch Mike install the system at my house. It comes with, I believe, 10 8-foot sections, so 80 feet. Of pipe to run up and snake through the attic. So it will come with your hose reel, your unit, all your accessories, and all the stuff you need for hide-a-hose, which would be the on-wall box, either on-wall or in-wall box, and then all the piping, a bunch of elbows and 90s and things like that you would need to do it. I believe that each solution is coming with, that bag has lasted me like a year. I've had this thing in here using it, and so I think we're shipping it with one bag and might be two. All that will be in the description on the website. So the OG vacuum solution, lots of more stuff. I just wanted to give you a real rough intro to this setup. We'll be talking about doing this is an external, like if you had a external collection tank, if you had a detailing shop and you really were sucking up all kinds of funky crap and you're filling up your bags all the time. We do have a dust collection or extra collection unit that can be used and be plumbed in. We'll be launching that in the future. So full suite of stuff coming, but right now I wanted to launch what I'm using, what I have, and it's this guy right here. I'm telling you, it is freaking fantastic. And then we have some videos. It's been in every video, every wash and talk. So I have a bunch of videos that are showing it in operation. But just again, bear with me. Lots coming on comparisons, testing. I'm formulating and figuring out ways to test and capture suction values that are more accurate, more real-world accurate. We're going to be developing accessories, developing hoses, all of that stuff. But for now, I wanted to have a system that I've been using, that I like, that's working really well with accessories that are functional, hose reel, a hose that I really like, and have it be super, super quiet, super unobtrusive, and make it really, really easy. I would highly suggest you do, if you're not going to do the hide-a-hose system, do the hose reel. I also didn't like that if you buy the Cox hose reel without the hose, it's like, I think the hose reel is like $400 or $390 or something like that. If you buy it with a hose, it's like $700. And the hose is like $50 or $100 or something like that. And so I decided we went out and sourced our own hose and try to make it as efficient as possible. The less money this is, the more I'm going to sell. So we want to try to keep costs down as much as possible. So what I'm doing is I'm leveraging the expertise of Grant from Modern Day. Most of these vacuums all use motors from the same company. The company is called Amatech. Amatech makes pretty much all of them, with the exception of the really cheap ones that use a Chinese knockoff. Amatech has like 150 or 200 different motors. So I'm leveraging Modern Day's expertise. They've bought and tried all of them. Not only tried them, but I've had them in the field, been using them for decades. And so I'm leveraging his expertise. I like the fit, the finish, the look, the style. And so we're branding this the Obsessed Garage Vacuum. You can't get this on their store. They custom made this for us. For the automotive space, most of the ones you see, you know, they're just not very good. This thing is freaking awesome. So go Go to obsessedgarage.com if you're an Inside the Hex member. We'll launch it for the rest of you the week after. Get your spot in line, and we'll be shipping over the next couple of months. So thanks for watching. If you have any questions, shoot me an email or Tommy an email, matt@obsessedgarage.com or tommy@obsessedgarage.com. You can shoot us an email. We'll be happy to, you know, share with you whatever information. Kyle, also kyle@obsessedgarage.com, and the design team, if you're doing a garage, he's pretty well versed in this as well. We are, I'd say, about 30% of the way there to being full subject matter experts. Right now, the unit is 100% vetted, 100% works, functions really well. I would feel comfortable early adopting. You can buy this and have it for 10 or 15, 20 years. And then as we launch new accessories, I mean, these accessories are kind of throwaways. They're not that much money. And so as we develop new accessories, sort of one at a time, you can buy those and continue to improve your system. We're going to continue to chase that, much like we've done with pressure washing. Many of you started with the base MTM gun that I sold, and then we got the Mosmatic that I sold, and then the new OG spec Mosmatic, the OG hose, the different fittings. And so we developed that over time, so you've been able to upgrade your system. But even the very first Krenzel purchasers, many of them are still operating with that first system that I put together. Same thing with this. This is our first version of it that is fully vetted, and then we'll continue to improve and chase perfection as time goes on. So thanks for your support. Thanks for bearing with me on vacuums. Many of you didn't wait and bought something. I'm telling you, we'll never use another vacuum. Wait till you see this thing. Wait till you see people's reviews of this thing. It's freaking awesome. So thanks for watching. See you on the next video.
Pretty slick, huh? Way better than a reel, I think. You know, if you want total clean look, you know. But some people like the look of a reel and everything outside. So either way, you can't lose.